In your previous math classes, you've most likely used the TI graphing calculators, but a tool that's very likely to be new to you is a website called WolframAlpha. So this is a computational knowledge engine, is how the company refers to what this product is. But basically what it is a free online tool that can answer just about any math question we could dream up. So what we want to do is take a look at solving a couple of problems just using some basic features here, types of problems that we'll come back to throughout the semester, but just to kind of start to get a preview of what this software can do. Throughout the semester, as we need this tool, we'll make a point of introducing how to use it. In general, it's quite intuitive. For instance, you could type something like 2 times 3 if you wanted to complete just a simple multiplication operation. It's always going to output a number of different answers, so kind of answers in different forms. In this case, really what we would probably care about is that 2 times 3 is 6. So that would be sort of typing that in a math language. But it's also fairly intuitive and can sort of understand basic English commands. So if we told it to multiply 2 and 3, it's going to be able to interpret that as 2 times 3, which gives us 6. So there's going to be certain times where we have to use some slightly more formal terminology in order to get the results we want. Other times it's sort of just going to be typing basic English, just sort of telling the software what do you want it to do. So in this first homework question that we're going to take a look at, we want to find the solution set for this following inequality. So we want to solve x squared plus 7x is greater than 0. So in Wolfram Alpha, we'll just ask it to do that. Solve x squared plus 7x is greater than 0. So there's always going to be this input interpretation step or box. It's always a good idea to just double check that, make sure this matches what you think you should be doing, in case you have a typo or the software decided to interpret something a little bit differently. But then it's going to give us our results in a couple of different forms. It's going to give us the result as a number line. It's going to give us the result as a pair of inequalities. So we can see that x should be less than negative 7 or x should be greater than 0. One trick here is going to be that this question is actually going to ask for that answer in interval notation. So the first part of that answer was telling us that x should be less than negative 7. So in interval notation, that would mean negative infinity to negative 7 with rounded parentheses, since this is a strict inequality. We'll use this union symbol to join two intervals. So our second interval will be x greater than 0. So our second interval will start at 0 and continue on to infinity. So to do that work by hand isn't impossible. It would take a little bit of work to come up with that answer. But using Wolfram Alpha, we can jump right to that result. And when we're using Wolfram Alpha in this class, that will be what we'll be doing. We'll use Wolfram Alpha to jump directly to results and then focus more on interpretation, applying these different calculus concepts to business applications. The other example we want to look at and that we'll use throughout the semester is constructing a linear regression model. So there's actually two questions here. We'll just look at half of this. In the first half of this question, we want a linear regression model for, let's see, men's 100 meter freestyle times. So we have our, what should be our x coordinate is the year, and then the data for men in that first column. So switching back to Wolfram Alpha, again, what we want to do is take this data and fit it to a linear model. So this is going to be a case where we need a slightly more specific command. We're going to say linear fit, which means take this data that we're about to enter and fit it to a linear model. And then we're just going to input the data as xy coordinates. Now what we're told is x is the year since 1980. So in place of 1980, we're actually going to represent that with a 0. And then our value is 50.4. So we'll type that as a coordinate pair. Then separate with a comma, our next coordinate pair is 1984. So that would be 4 years after 1980. And our y value would be 49.8. I'm going to go ahead and pause the video here where I type in the rest of this data just to skip ahead. So I've gone ahead and finished typing in this data. Again, my x-coordinate is representing the year since 1980. My y-coordinate is just that list of values under men. Started off with that command linear fit, and then go ahead and evaluate this either by hitting that equals button or pressing enter on your keyboard. So again, we can get rid of this little box that popped up. We can check this input interpretation just to make sure this makes sense. So what it's looking at is these lists of data points. It's constructing a linear function, and then the least squares best fit, or essentially the regression model, that linear equation for that data, is given to us right here. So all we would need to do is take this result, type it into our box, and in this case we're being told to round each of those to 3 decimal places. But essentially we've got that result. You'll do the same thing for the data on women, and then in this last homework question, we're going to do something very similar, except instead you're going to be constructing a quadratic regression model. So that process will be very similar. The only thing that will change is obviously the data that we enter here. I'm just going to leave these data points just as an example. And instead of this being linear fit, you would change that to quadratic fit. So what we get is our polynomial of degree 2, or our quadratic equation. So again, we would have our results to type in each of those coefficients in those boxes. The one catch here being that this first number is going to be entered in scientific notation. So instead of typing in 0.00004129.46, it's just going to ask you to convert that to some number times 10 to the negative 6. So make that conversion for scientific notation. If you have any questions while we're using Wolfram Alpha throughout the semester, or even just through any of these introductory questions, please feel free to contact me. But again, as we introduce the new features, we'll make a point in the videos of demonstrating how to obtain those results as we go.